Sri Purushottam was fair, medium built man, with a strong physique, muscles of iron, nerves of steel, with a spine made of the same thing of which the thunderbolt is made. Swami Vivekananda was on a lookout for youngsters with such traits, for his man-making and nation-building mission would have easily picked up Sri Purushottam had he been born during that time. But Sri Purushottam had in him something more, a strong, daring mind that was nonchalant. No wonder he rarely showed his emotions in public. The maximum that one could see from him was a grin. Born on 1st January 1922, he was a perfect Capricorn, sunshine. Born as the son of Srimati Kaveri and Sri Giri Prabhu, Sri Purushottam was the grandson of Sri Govinda Prabhu and great-grandson of Sri Vamana Prabhu and great-great-grandson of Sri Kalika Prabhu. It was Sri Kalika Prabhu, a successful businessman, an advisor to the Dutch governor, who donated his sprawling campus at Karnakodam, Tammanam, Ernakulam in 1769 AD for the construction of Venkatachalapati Temple. Is the same Sri Kalika Prabhu who, while on a pilgrimage to Rameshwaram, chanced to see a beautiful idol of Hanuman, brought it to Kochi and handed it over to the Kochi Tirumala Temple for installation. But hidden behind that strong traits lay a trait that was in love with one that was so soft by nature, arts and instrumental music. In that, Kathakali, top dalish, followed by Thayambagam, Chandavadyam and Nadaswaram. His love for it took him to some of the most famous temple festivals of Kingdom of Kochi, the erstwhile princely state that consisted of the present Ernakulam district and some parts of Thrissur and Palakkad districts in Kerala. Perhaps that period also saw Sri Purushottam getting acquainted with the people who were in rebellion with certain established norms of the GSB community. But luckily, the presence of the Dharma Guru of Kashimad, Srimad Sukratindra Tirtha, with his Sishya Swami, Srimad Sudindra Tirtha in Kochi for the Chaturmasya Vritta of 1949 AD was the turning point. A few from that group vowed in his divine presence to make a clean break with the past. Sri Purushottam was one among them. Marriage with Sulabha, daughter of Sri Narasimha Bhat and Saraswati, mellowed Sri Purushottam further. Sulabha was a very fair and beautiful girl with an equally beautiful heart that could accommodate everyone from the large family that she was married to. Values like devotion to God and love and concern for the family members was ingrained in her mind right from the childhood by the parents. Sulabha was the girl next door, south street of the Kochi Tirumala Devasam temple, but had no clue about Sri Purushottam. Those days, functions related to marriage were simple, with only close and family members attending. There was nothing like formal seeing the girl, Uttaralavap, Vest, Phoolamalav, etc., all meaningless functions, high on expenses but low on outcomes, that have become the biggest money guzzlers, driving families into abyss of debts. This is what Sulabha said about how it happened in her life 6 decades back.
Ama yang main kor, si anak, abah angkat panjiran, di kan, serta dalam Shivratri kor, cak, kacchee itu cak ni yang main, ama yang main kor, ratiya tay, angge ni, சட்டை அதை சிறக்கடு சோடியனி அங்கே வெனி வித்தர்வெனி இதை கண்ணடே ஏச்சி பாயிரின் பாயிரின் சரிங்க பாயிரு போடணும் அவனுக்கு அழுதான் பாயிரு போடணும் அன்னைக்கு வச்சவளை காலத்தை பார்த்து அஞ்சலினா பாயிரும் சனி போடணும் கேட்டாயி தசி கற்கடு அவ்வளோ முடிஞ்சுதா போ இத்தான மேங்கேனி செடிதாக்கும் சாக்கே ஓ
Jayanti was the couple's first child, born within an year of the marriage. Births of four more children, three boys and one girl, followed, making them a complete family. Sri Purushottam's relationship with Sulabha and the children was just wonderful, always addressing her as Maye. Never ever had he used a harsh word against her or the children. All his children vouch this even now. Sri Purushottam had a very high respect for the elder brother, Sri Sarvottam, whom he referred in the most esteemed way as Cheta, the elder brother, even in private conversations. For him, even a mere signal from his Cheta was a command to be executed, come what may. Though many are the instances, for the sake of brevity, none is narrated here. The elder brother too reciprocated back equally by showering his love and concern in abundance. The crowning glory of that surely would be helping Sri Purushottam get a job in Brook Bond India Limited, one of the top multinational companies that had its export division in Wellington Island, Kochi. And that perhaps was the time Sri Purushottam made a new beginning in life by focusing on the job wholeheartedly. That made one of the top directors of the company to admit Sri Purushottam as the backbone of the warehousing section of his export division. Such was his command on the logistics. He could effortlessly carry out within the set deadlines shipments of huge export orders running into hundreds of tons that appeared well nigh impossible for his colleagues. He had by then also picked up technical aspects of tea and in innumerable grades based on size, shape, appearance, color, taste and smell. Sri Purushottam was a professional to the core. In his earliest stint in a leading timber mill, he had picked up all the nuances of the timber trade, in-depth understanding about the different types of trees and its qualities that surprised even seasoned carpenters later. For him, the intricate measurements of wooden roof were a simple thing. He was a born civil engineer, come architect, and knew the intricacies of designs, detailed estimates, technicalities of foundation, RCC beams and RCC roofs, floors, plastering, painting, etc. He also could keep detailed date-wise accounts. Starting from his own younger brother's house, he was instrumental in construction of most of the new houses of his relatives in Kochi and faraway places. All that he did selflessly out of love for them. Thanks to that, construction was always of top quality at the barest minimum cost.